It's Press Pass with Jack Ebling, Mid-Michigan spirited sports debate. Now let's get talking sports. Here's Jack.
Great evening, Mid-Michigan and beyond, and welcome to Press Pass here on Fox 47. It's time to meet Team 355. DeShaun Tate, Lansing-bred, Atlanta-based basketball savant. It's Tate's Take Hoops, where basketball lives, right?
No other place to live.
I want to talk to you about how much you have missed NBA playoffs this summer. Are you okay?
I think so. Everyone else would probably disagree with that, but so far I've been doing okay. And I brought out something very special for you tonight, Jack. You know what this is? That is my excited for basketball to almost be around. And on top of that, that's my Michigan State winning a recruiting battle dance right there. That's what that is.
We haven't seen this too often from DeShaun. Also want to welcome Matt Charboneau. Does a great job covering Michigan State football and basketball for the Detroit News. He is a serious softball dad, and he is an astute observer of the political scene and social landscape. How are you, Matt?
Fabulous. I'm not a savant at anything, Jack. Come on. I mean, I don't have a dance for you or anything, but I do my best.
Well, you were just in Ohio, right? The tournament scene for softball. What happened?
Well, that's the story of my life this summer, really. I mean, all the Michigan teams have flooded Ohio, so my daughter's teams have done the same. And, you know, it's been up and down, but it's been fun. It's good. You know, it's really good to actually get out there and kind of feel a little bit normal. It's not exactly the same as it used to be nowadays. But it is kind of that you're at least getting a sports fix, which is something I think we're all looking forward to. Hopefully can come back again soon.
Normally, this is the time of year where you get a little bit of rest, maybe some vacation. Before we get into the start of college football, we would be going to Big Ten Media Days and then getting ready for the start of the 2020 season. You might have a little bit more time off than we thought.
But yeah, looks like it. I mean, we'll have to see, obviously, but we'll see if the NBA gets going, if NHL gets going. We're all waiting on baseball to start, hopefully. Football up in the air. As we know around here in Big Ten country, if they do play in the fall, it'll be different. So, it's normally a slow time, but we're in that strange time of wondering what's going to come next. And I think that's what we've all been doing, kind of guessing and speculating what's next and how it's going to look. So that's kind of where we're at right now.
One thing that I can relate to that you've had to do is kill some time. Between seasons, you ready to kill another 6 months?
Oh, come on, Jack. Don't tell me that we're trying to be optimistic here. Come on. Give me a break.
We will be back in just a minute, and we're going to spend a ton of time today on college basketball. We're going to talk recruiting. We're going to talk about Max Christie. We're going to talk about Amani Bates. We're going to talk about Jaden Akins. We're going to talk about Cody Bufkin. We're going to talk about recruiting Michigan State and Michigan. Coming up next here on Press Pass.
We are MEA, a foundation of collective strength, an advocate for education. K-12 educators, support professionals, and higher education employees united to support our students, our schools, and our community. Together, we are the shield protecting every student's right to succeed. Michigan Education Association. Champions for Education.
As the pandemic went on, we saw between 30 and 40% of an increase in those who were hungry and needed to find food in some other way.
Fox 47 made a challenge to Mid-Michigan.
There is something about living in Mid-Michigan. People come forward and help each other.
Help donate over 50,000 meals to local families in need in just 1 week.
To do this kind of thing in just a week's time is really unheard of.
Every single dollar raised, we can provide 3 meals. The need has never been greater.
And the response was overwhelming.
Hats off to you, Mid-Michigan, for stepping up to help your neighbors in need. We have hit our goal of more than 50,000 meals.
Got the calculator here. We just raised 69,360 meals for Mid-Michigan. So I'm really proud and really appreciative of the entire Greater Lansing Food Bank team.
Thank you, Mid-Michigan, for your generous donations. Join the Yes Club and be a winner today.
At Graff Chevrolet in Oakmont, you'll always get a great deal on a huge selection of high-quality used cars and trucks. But you'll also get something else. peace of mind. Every Graff used vehicle purchase comes with up to 6 oil changes for the first 2 years of ownership. We'll also give you a free tire rotation with every other oil change. Always a great selection of used vehicles starting from $1,000 and up. Check them out at GraffOkemos.com. Lower your cost of ownership with our Peace of Mind program, only at Graff Chevrolet in Okemos.
So, I got my start in officiating when a friend told me I should try it. At first, I just did basketball, and I got hooked. Before long, I added baseball, softball, football, and volleyball. I really enjoyed giving back to the game, working with kids, and working with my local association to recruit and train new officials. I would like to say to anybody that officiating is a great way to help kids and stay connected to the game. We always need new officials. There's help wanted, just listen.
Welcome back to Press Pass here on Fox 47. It's time for The Big Picture, brought to you by Dean Transportation. Dean is hiring caring and dependable people as school bus drivers in many Michigan markets. Be a hero in your community and safely transport children to and from school with Dean. For more information and to apply, visit deantransportation.com/jobs. That's deantransportation.com/jobs.
This is not a fait accompli that we're going to have sports in the fall. We may not have sports in the fall. We may not have a college football season in the Big Ten. And so we just wanted to make sure that this was a next logical step to always to rely on our medical experts to keep our student athletes at the center of all of our decisions and make sure that they are as healthy as they possibly can be from a mental, a physical, and emotional health and wellness standpoint.
Matt Charboneau, that was not the most important decision that Kevin Warren will make or the most important announcement he will make this summer, but shifting to a conference-only schedule for the fall, is that a step in the right direction, or is that just delaying the inevitable in terms of cancellation, at least until spring?
I mean, I guess the cynical view would be, yes, this is just a step towards the inevitable. But I feel like it's also a necessary step. If you want to try and control this to any extent, I think keeping it in conference is a pretty good idea. So you have the same testing protocols, all the same safety issues from one school to the next. You know, if you're Michigan going out to Washington, you're not sure if they're going to be doing it exactly the same as the schools in the Big Ten. So at least offers you a little bit of control if you're playing. Now, again, that cynical view is, will they be playing at all? Because as you heard him say in those interviews, you saw in the statement, the key word in there is if they're playing this fall, if there's games to be played, this is how they'll do it. I know a lot of people think this is just the first, and then down the road we're going to find out they're not actually playing. But I think you have to plan for if you are, and I think this is probably the necessary step to do that.
DeShaun Tate, one day after Kevin Warren announced what the Big Ten's plans were, the Pac-12 followed suit. Does this mean the SEC, the ACC, the Big 12 will be doing the same thing?
I don't think that there's really a choice that can be made here. I think it's more of a matter of when, not necessarily if, especially considering the fact that, you know, we might be considering looking at a second wave of the coronavirus, you know. Specifically within these SEC and ACC country, Florida, Georgia, those two particular states that are now, you know, two states that have institutions that play within them and are now at stage one, essential only all over again. They're kind of resetting and starting all over again. But on top of that, how do you even evaluate a particular conference that is playing 12 games versus one that plays 8? I'm not sure really exactly how that'll measure up.
Matt, the Big Ten canceled 42 non-conference games, including 5 high-profile games. And we look at those, and then we check the schedules for Michigan State and Michigan and the games that are going to be scrubbed with that. What percent chance is there that we'll have all 70 conference games, 10 per school, and it will finish up in late November as planned?
What are the chances? I personally don't feel like they're great. To be honest with you, I just feel like we're kind of seeing where this thing's going, right? And it doesn't feel great to me. Look, I would love if by the end of November we've seen Big Ten teams all play 10 conference games. They managed to have some sort of conference champion. I don't know if they'll have a championship game. I think it would be great. I just feel like if we're looking at all the numbers that DeShaun was just referencing, it just doesn't feel like it's going in a good direction to me. If they're playing in the fall, I see that as kind of, I'd be surprised if we're doing that, to be honest.
Do you think we're going to have these games rescheduled? We're going to get Toledo at Michigan State at some point. We're going to get Michigan State returning that game with BYU and the series with Miami. Is it just pushing it down the road?
I mean, it could, but the problem is now you've got all your contracts with all the other teams and all these other subsequent years. You have those to deal with. You have TV deals to worry about. There's a lot up in the air. I know they're going to try and work, and maybe you can kick, say, the BYU game down a few years in Miami, but it's tough to do when you schedule so far out. So that might be wishful thinking. I know I've heard that from some ADs, whether it was Wisconsin or the Washington AD, of how they're trying to work things out. It's just difficult to do when you schedule as far out as these teams do.
DeShaun, will we have conference championship games and a seventh college football playoff?
I don't think so. You know, I know that a lot of times we try to compare the two between the college football and the college basketball. I think that this is more so about what's going to happen with the NBA. They're going to be the ones that kind of set the precedence, and everything else as far as the rest of the sports are really going to be the ones to follow.
If we don't have football, are we going to have college basketball in 2021?
I'm not a believer, and I don't think that college football is necessarily the one that sets the precedence. I think the one that will be is the NBA. They're going to be the ones that is ultimately going to be the guinea pigs.
Wow. It's hard to imagine, gentlemen, that we could have 2 years without an NCAA tournament. I think about all that revenue, but I also think about all the lives that could be lost. Saw tonight, as of 4 o'clock, we have 137,000 COVID-19 related deaths in the United States. That is a ton. We will be back, and we're going to take a look at the future for college basketball in the state of Michigan, Michigan State, and U of M. We're going to start with Max Christie and Imani Bates up next here on Press Pass.
A new day dawns, and we greet it with gratitude. Thankful for the heroes on the front lines taking big risks daily to keep us safe, we at Dean Transportation stand at the ready with them, supporting our communities in their time of need. We've been delivering food and medical supplies, volunteering our time, and boosting morale to keep spirits high. Our passengers may have temporarily changed, but our commitment to transporting your most precious cargo has never wavered. Dean Transportation, working together, delivering the good.
At Graf Chevrolet in Oakmont, you'll always get a great deal on a huge selection of high-quality used cars and trucks. But you'll also get something else, peace of mind. Every Graf used vehicle purchase comes with up to 6 oil changes for the first 2 years of ownership. We'll also give you free tire rotation with every other oil change. Always a great selection of used vehicles starting from $1,000 and up. Check them out at GrafOakmont.com. Lower your cost of ownership with our Peace of Mind program, only at Graf Chevrolet in Okemos.
Download the Fox 47 News app and stay connected everywhere you go.
Celebrate your freedom in style and save big during the extended July 4th sale at Furniture Row. Shop today and get huge discounts on every sofa, every dining table, and every bed. Plus, save up to $500 on all Tempur-Breeze mattresses and get 4 years no interest and free shipping right to your doorstep. Shop the largest selection at the lowest prices guaranteed and discover that fresh new summer look. Hurry, the extended July 4th sale at Furniture Row ends soon.
Downtown Lansing is open for business.
Now open in downtown Lansing, Goodfellas Bagel Deli. High-quality bagel sandwiches with a mafioso flair. Stop in today, dine in, or carry out on the Pier Marquette corner. We'll treat you like family.
Want to get out of your lease? Over on Miles? Maybe you just want to drive something different. Whatever the reason, Shaheen Chevrolet will get you out of your current lease and into a newer model, usually for less than you're paying now. Even if your lease isn't with us, trade up and pay less at Shaheen Chevrolet, where you always get the lowest price on any new Chevy, guaranteed, or it's free.
Welcome back to Press Pass here on Fox 47. Time for a Going Green segment brought to you by Graf Chevrolet and Graf Nissan on West Grand River in Okemos. With 106 years in the automobile business, they'll take great care of you as they have on all 7 of my leases and purchases for a new or used vehicle. Go green, go Graf.
All right, so I'll let you handle this part. This is your announcement. This is your moment. Where will you attend college in the fall of 2021?
Yep. I will be committing to Michigan State, Coach Izzo, his staff, and my future teammates.
All right. Obviously, this has been a great couple of weeks for Michigan State. Number one in the class of 2022, Imani Bates, has announced he's committing to Michigan State. You're the class before. We'll see if Bates can reclassify and get into your class. Why Michigan State?
Yeah, no, Michigan State, I mean, my relationship with Coach Izzo was, I feel like it was great. It just felt like it was, you know, a place that I was needed and a place that I wanted to go to. And when I took my official visit there back at the beginning of the year, I mean, it just felt like it was just that gut feeling that I felt it was right for me just to be able to go there and just experience the college life. And I think Coach Izzo, his staff, and all my teammates there can push me to be the person that I want to be, not only on but off the court.
DeShaun Tate, how did Tom Izzo land Max Christie, 6'6", 185 pounds, Rolling Meadows, Illinois, serious student athlete, and the nation's number one shooting guard?
I like to think the same way that all the elite coaches landed their elite talent. However, when you have the opportunity to sell a guy like Christie on the fact that he could potentially play with Imani Bates in the event that Bates reclassifies, in the event that he doesn't, you still have opportunities at getting more touches if you're Christie, being that guy with the ball in your hands a lot more often. And I don't know exactly if it was a package deal or not, but the younger brother, Christie, was offered a scholarship by Michigan State first, so there is a potential package deal there.
Matt Charboneau, Max Christie, much more than just a sniper from long range. He's also a four-point student. He's a facilitator and defender. And I said he's kind of a hybrid of Steve Smith, Chris Hill, and Gary Harris at a similar age. What do you make of his potential as a Spartan?
No, I mean, obviously the potential is unlimited at this point. You talk about the kind of guy he is when you talk about his grade point average and when you speak to him, really well-spoken kid. I had someone tell me he was a prototypical Duke guy, had a Duke tattoo on his forehead, he just didn't know it, you know, and this is the kind of guy normally that would end up at Duke. Yet when you really start looking at some of the guys Michigan State has gotten over the years, you brought up Gary Harris, I think is a perfect example. Whether Denzel Valentine, you make that comparison too. But you've heard Tom Izzo reference it a lot the last couple of years of getting our kind of guys. And this is, as much as you say he might have been a perfect Duke guy, he really fits that Michigan State bill too, of a guy who can do a lot of different things. And when you talk to him, you hear him talk about, you don't talk about what he can do scoring. He talks about what he's doing to help the team to win. And I think that kind of fits into that Michigan State kind of guy that they've been talking about the last couple of years, what they've really been after.
DeShaun, Max Christie, the first Chicagoland player that Mike Krzyzewski has failed to get, that he's really gone after. When you look at what he has done and what he is capable of doing, why were so many smart people so wrong about Max Christie?
Well, you know what? Smart people, I like to think that I'm one of those people because I also thought that he was one of the guys that was not going to go to Michigan State, going to spurn Michigan State and go to Duke. But the reason why that is because there's been no history or very few history of players that decide to choose Michigan State over Duke. And then even then when those things happen, sometimes I wonder how bad did Coach K or that other opposing coach really want that
player? But it's easy to say when you don't get somebody, well, we didn't really want him. You know, we see that all the time. They just lost him. That's what it was. Matt, when you think about this coming on the heels of Imani Bates, what does it say, Michigan State getting 2 5-star guys in that short a time?
Well, it's, you know, you see the Imani Bates part of it is just doesn't feel normal. So you kind of throw that out and you think Max Christie, they get a 5-star guy every couple of years. So to me, it's kind of, yeah, it's great to get them and Duke wanted them. But to me, it's kind of, this is what Michigan State does. Now, if they keep landing them, you might think it's at another level. But, you know, you're going to supplement them with some 4-star guys. This feels like a Michigan State class.
We will be back in just a minute tracking a trophy. We're going to talk about the Michigan State lineup for next year. And Jaden Akins up next.
My name is Lauren and I'm the Atomic Ant.
You don't want to mess with somebody that has blue hair.
My background is parkour. Last year, people started calling me La Hormiga Atomica, which translates to the Atomic Ant.
I loved it.
I think it describes me perfectly.
Atomic ant. Her size makes her deadly in the dome.
It's a short joke. I'm short, and it's also a superhero. I'm just a person who likes to jump around. Now I'm getting paid to do it. I'm afraid of heights, but once I'm inside the dome, it's over. I can quadruped really fast.
The ant is closing in. Ah, he's gassed.
They call me the Atomic Ant, but you're the one getting exterminated.
Big Bang Cartier Prototype, Sheldon. The Big Bang Theory, 5 nights a week.
At Graf Chevrolet in Oakmont, you'll always get a great deal on a huge selection of high-quality used cars and trucks. But you'll also get something else. Peace of mind. Every Graf used vehicle purchase comes with up to 6 oil changes for the first 2 years of ownership. We'll also give you free tire rotation with every other oil change. Always a great selection of used vehicles starting from $1,000 and up. Check them out at GrafOakmont.com. Lower your cost of ownership with our Peace of Mind program, only at Graf Chevrolet in Oakmont.
What's really important to me is being able to have a partner, and Dart Bank has been that for me. I'm Eric Nelson. I'm a managing partner here at the English Inn. I've worked with John Morris at Dart Bank to help put together multiple projects that have assisted us with growing our business and continuing to be successful.
You're out. There's an old saying, you can never have too many officials. The age of the average official is 52 and getting older all the time. We're constantly recruiting new people, younger people, to join us. After you register with the MHSAA, look on the website to find an officials association near you. They'll put you in a position to succeed as an official. We all learned a lot from high school sports, and officiating is a great way to give back to the game. There's help wanted, just whistle.
Touchdown, champion.
Welcome back to Press Pass here on Fox 47. Time for our Tracking a Trophy segment, brought to you by the Ticket Machine at the corner of Mount Hope and Hagedorn. For the best in sports and entertainment ticketing, whenever those events resume, go to theticketmachine.com. There you see Michigan State's tentative roster. And Matt Charboneau, it is certainly possible, if not likely, that Xavier Tillman will stay in the NBA draft. But if he is back, could this be as deep a roster as Tom Izzo has had in 26 seasons?
I mean, it sure could be, especially when you're talking about on the wing and certainly up front if Xavier Tillman is back. The only question you have, of course, is that point guard, because you're kind of now a little bit up in the air. Is Rocket Watts going to play there? Are you counting on a guy like Foster Lawyer, who through 2 years has not really proven he can really excel at this level other than spot minutes? Are you relying on a freshman like A.J. Hoggard? That's really the only thing that the only question you have going in, the only thing that maybe keeps you from saying this lineup doesn't have many holes in it. It's really strong and really deep at some spots, but you just wonder about that point guard spot and who might kind of take over from in that kind of main role once they actually do start playing.
I don't think it's that tough a question, because if you have Joshua Langford coming back, he's going to be your shooting guard as he was for 2.5 years, and then it means you got to have a place for Rocket Watts. And so if you have Rocket Watts and Joshua Langford in your backcourt, how many Big Ten schools can match that, DeShaun?
Big Ten schools, not a whole lot, but I think that this is a program that does have to go through Big Ten first, but also has realistic expectations to look beyond that. So while there are some loopholes and question marks at the point guard position, especially backing up, even in the front court offensively, I think they have some questions and consistency on those wings, where you have to get some of those guys between Henry, amongst others, like Brown, to play together all at the same time.
There are no perfect programs. If you want perfection, you have to see DeShaun's podcast.
Big if, too, Jack, on Joshua Langford. I mean, we're
talking about a big if we're going to have a season.
Yeah, we're talking about an if on Xavier Tillman. I mean, Josh Langford's a pretty big if too. If he's there, you're right. I mean, yeah, it's easy to move Rocket Watts, but that's a pretty big wild card right now.
DeShaun, this might sound silly, but is it possible to have too many players who think that they should be getting minutes? Or would any coach in the country say, I'll take competitive practices, I'll take injury insurance, I'll take lineup flexibility, and worry about the egos down the road.
I'm sure that there's coaches that would love to have that talent and love to have too many players that are going to want too many minutes. And while that's obviously a really good thing, you have, like, look at the NBA right now, like a team like a Denver Nuggets, who has so much talent on that roster, but not nearly enough role players of guys who's not really worried about scoring amongst other things. So while it's a good thing, it can certainly be a gift and a curse.
Matt, I want to talk about Michigan State now in terms of another high school star who may be committing. We talk about Imani Bates, whether or not he would reclassify, and will he play at Michigan State? We know Max Christie is going to. We know that Pierre Brooks Jr. is the first one to commit. But Jaden Akins, a 6'3 and growing guard from Farmington High School. And when I look at him, I see De'Aaron Fox with a better shot. Former Michigan State All-American was telling me last week that there's really nothing this guy can't do. If you add him to the mix, what does that say for the class of 2021?
It says you've put together one heck of a class, because what was I just talking about? The thing you're uncertain about on this team is point guard. That it may end up not being an issue, but you're talking about adding a point guard who a lot of schools are after would just kind of sort of make this class. And I mean, if you throw Imani Bates in that with Max Christie, with Pierre Brooks, and add Jaden Akins, I mean, you're looking back to the four guy class of 16 with Miles, Nick Ward, Josh Lang for Cassius Winston. That's the sort of class you're talking about. Probably, I mean, if you look at the rankings, probably might be a little bit higher. So the expectations will be there. And if you add him to that class, man, expectations would be through the roof at that point.
Akins is a guy who looks like he can score at all levels. And someone said to Sean that if he does play on a team with Max Christie and with Imani Bates, that there are going to be some assist records in jeopardy in the Big Ten and at Michigan State. We saw Mateen Cleaves get 20 assists against Michigan. We saw Cassius Winston with a season assist record. You got a lot of guys to throw the ball to. You should be able to get some assists.
Yeah, I like to think the exact same thing. This is a guy who does that very well. And he can score as well, but scoring is not really something that he necessarily has to do. To sit back with all that talent around him, kind of like what Drew Neitzel had at one point in time when he had Mo Egger on wing at one point, right, and then Shannon Brown on the other one. Got a big man in the middle. I mean, sky's the limit for this team in the event that they can land someone like him.
Matt, when you think that Michigan also got a nice commitment, Kobe B, not Bryant, Kobe Bufkin from Grand Rapids Christian this week. That gives Juwan Howard three pledges ranked between numbers 78 and 149. What does that mean for the Wolverines?
That means they're getting foundational pieces and they got a lot of scholarships to fill. You're going after big name guys, but you need these sort of guys too, those foundational pieces. They're going to be 2-3-4 year guys that I think is important when you're trying to turn things around there.
We'll be right back with our Law of the Jungle segment, talking Detroit Tigers and Lions. Yes, they still exist. We'll be right back.
At Graff Chevrolet in Oakmont, you'll always get a great deal on a huge selection of high-quality used cars and trucks. But you'll also get something else, peace of mind. Every Graff used vehicle purchase comes with up to 6 oil changes for the first 2 years of ownership. We'll also give you free tire rotation with every other oil change. Always a great selection of used vehicles starting from $1,000 and up. Check them out at GraffOakmont.com. Lower your cost of ownership with our Peace of Mind program, only at Graff Chevrolet in Okemos.
Anyone who's had our chicken knows it's plump and juicy. What they may not know is that it's also 100% natural.
All our chickens are certified, humanely raised, no antibiotics, on a high quality diet of soy and grain.
Why are they called tenders?
They're called tenders because they come from the tenderloin to the breast, hand trimmed just for colors. It's not a strip or a finger, it is the true tenderloin.
I'll put our chicken tenders up against anybody's.
That's like my Granny Franklin used to make. That's outstanding, Greg.
Welcome to Delicious.
You're wasting time. Just make a left right here.
I know how to get there.
The app says there's a shortcut.
The app can suck it. I know LA.
I got you.
Let me help you.
I already have a partner.
Why do I always have to play the good cop? Time's up. No matter what happens, I got you.
We're going to take him down.
The right way. Like an official duo. Like Starsky and Hutch.
Stick together and we're going to get it done.
Get back on track. Visit fox47news.com/rebound.
We are MEA.
A foundation of collective strength. An advocate for education. K through 12 educators, support professionals, and higher education employees, united to support our students, our schools, and our community. Together, we are the shield protecting every student's right to succeed. Michigan Education Association, champions for education.
Hi, I need the stone in this ring replaced, and I have to have it done in 3 days. Is that something you could take care of?
Best I can do, 24 hours.
Yeah, okay. But do you do credit checks?
How about no credit checks?
Oh, wait, so 24-hour turnaround?
Yep.
And no credit check?
Correct. Do we have a deal?
We do.
Pawn Just Jewelry West for repairs, refits, new and custom jewelry. Just call 517-703-9677.
Welcome back to Press Pass here on Fox 47. It's time for our Law of the Jungle segment, brought to you by Woody's Oasis on Trowbridge Road, your healthy alternative to fast food. Eat Woody's and live longer. That's why I'm there every week. Here you see Spencer Torkelson, number one overall pick in the Major League Baseball draft from Arizona State, drafted as a third baseman, but he was a first baseman for the Sun Devils. The first ball went to deep center. Second one went out. That third one, I think, is still going. Matt Charboneau, I'm not sure why Spencer Torkelson was not drafted coming out of high school. A lot of teams made a mistake. He led the NCAA in home runs back-to-back seasons. If he hits half as well as it looks that he can, what does that mean for the Detroit Tigers moving forward?
Well, it means they're probably on track of what we call this rebuild at this point. When you think the last couple of years, they've now invested in some bats like Torkelson, Riley Green. The key now, obviously, is these guys kind of paying off. And obviously, the early returns are good on both guys. They spent so much time earlier investing in arms. But now you're seeing some of those young arms coming up that they could see this year, whether you know guys got like Casey Mize, Manning, guys like that. Are they going to get into the rotation this year? It's obviously a different year with a shortened season. But you kind of feel like all those pieces are starting to come now that you've seen these couple bats added the last couple of years. If Torkelson is the guy that we all expect him to be, I know there's no guarantees even at the number one pick, but if those two guys in particular kind of progress the way the Tigers expect, that tells you they're right on track with to where they need to be in this rebuild at this point.
DeShaun, when you see those seven first rounders, you got four pitchers, you got three position players, tons of potential, but no proven major league production. What do the Tigers have to see from those players in this shortened 2020 season to feel great about the future?
Well, it's very key that you mentioned one of the things I was going to say already, and the word is production. You've got to have a starting place. You've got to start from somewhere, anything in life. Production, growth, and to have pride within yourself to at least be able to put yourself in a position to compete. Sometimes, just like every day in life, you get so far down at the bottom of your luck, the only thing that you can do is go up from that standpoint. So you have to find have some type of mind of optimism and just try to work on what you have at that point and with those pieces to try and go up.
Matt Charboneau, the Detroit Lions, a different breed of cats. And I want to take a look at the Lions' seven head coaches since 2001. The much maligned Jim Caldwell, he was 36-28 with two playoff appearances from 2014-17. And he looks like Bill Belichick next to the rest of these guys. They went... If you look at the 15 other seasons, try 69-170. That's 101 more losses than wins with just one postseason game. What percent chance would you give Matt Patricia of ever winning a postseason game?
Oh, Jack, I'm telling you, I was at the last postseason victory in 1991 when they beat the Cowboys in the Silverdome. And another building in Oakland County that doesn't exist anymore. But anyway, when you look at those percentages, you got to say the percentages at this point of them winning, Matt Patricia doing it, pretty slim. I'm saying in the single digits. I mean, we almost saw them pull one off a few years ago in Dallas. I was at that one, too. I thought, wow, I'm going to see their second playoff win. You can talk about the refs all you want. But, I mean, come on. Track record with this program or this organization – anyone who feels optimistic, I hate to be a total cynic on this because it's so easy with the Lions, but if Matt Patricia's winning a playoff game, I will be the most shocked guy in the building.
DeShaun Tate, Bill Belichick was assistant special teams coach with the Lions in 1976. He was their receivers coach in 1977. If the Lions had hired Bill Belichick when he went to the Patriots in 2000, how would the fate of these two franchises have changed?
Wow, Jack, you're talking about in a perfect world here. Looking at this whole thing, I mean, it's easy for us to be able to say, look at all the things that Belichick has been able to do in New England, and you replace that over here in, you know, in Detroit. But it's obviously just not that easy. I like to think that it would be significantly better than what we have seen it, but to not only just win one Super Bowl, but to win multiple, I think that's a little bit of too much wishful thinking.
Matt, I wonder, given the choice, whether the Lions would rather have had Bill Belichick coaching, giving them structure, stability, leadership through that entire period, two decades, or whether they would have had Tom Brady at quarterback.
That's a good question. I mean, that's the debate you have in New England. Has it been more Belichick or Brady or both together? The funny thing I say, you ask if Bill Belichick would have been there in 2000, I've always had this feeling you could take whoever you think the best coach in NFL history is and put him in a Lions gear and on the Lions sideline, he automatically becomes worse as a coach. It's remarkable, really. So I don't know if Belichick being here back in 2000 would have dramatically changed the direction of this organization. Again, the cynical Lions fan in me.
Talking about being lionized, does that mean Tom Brady would have turned into Joey Harrington?
Perhaps. That might have happened. I don't know.
We will be back in just a minute, and we're going to have our Take It to the Bank segment coming up. We're going to talk about Patrick Mahomes. He's making DeShaun Tate kind of money up next.
Catch back-to-back episodes of Law & Order SVU Monday at 8 p.m. on My47.
What's really important to me is being able to have a partner, and Dart Bank has been that for me. I'm Eric Nelson. I'm a managing partner here at the English Inn. I've worked with John Morris at Dart Bank to help put together multiple projects that have assisted us with growing our business and continuing to be successful.
The Ticket Machine is your local connection to concert, theater, and sporting event tickets nationwide. Our entertainment experts are ready to help you create a memorable experience, trusted by fans for more than 20 years. Whether you're looking for tickets for your corporate outing, family excursion, or vacation, we offer the best seats and the best prices. Grab a front row seat now on theticketmachine.com.
A new day dawns and we greet it with gratitude. Thankful for the heroes on the front lines taking big risks daily to keep us safe. We at Dean Transportation stand at the ready with them, supporting our communities in their time of need. We've been delivering food and medical supplies, volunteering our time, and boosting morale to keep spirits high. Our passengers may have temporarily changed, but our commitment to transporting your most precious cargo has never wavered. Dean Transportation, working together, delivering the good.
Welcome back to Press Pass here on Fox 47. It's time for our Take It to the Bank segment, brought to you by Dart Bank, dedicated to meeting the needs of our banking community for more than 90 years, with four convenient locations in Mason, Holton, South Lansing, Grand Ledge, and the expanded Home Loan Center in Frandor. That's Dart Bank, for what matters most.
Why do I
flushed out again, all the way back. Turning the corner, fires downfield, caught, touchdown. Only Mahomes.
Launches down the middle, Hill, open, caught.
Matt Charboneau, if Patrick Mahomes is worth $503 million over the next 12 years, is it any surprise that it's stipulated in this contract he can't play baseball, he can't play basketball, he is allowed to cross the street, but only with the traffic signal?
Yeah, you might want to put a stipulation in there. He's wrapped in bubble wrap, too. I mean, a contract that long in football? I mean, think about it in a sport like baseball where you see it. No one's worth that by the end of their contract. You put him in a football environment and that length of a contract, is he going to be worth it at the end? Probably not. The key is, does it pay off early in the middle of that contract? Does it result in Super Bowls for the Chiefs? Then yeah, you're worth it at that point. But you're worth what the market gives you, too. So, he certainly has had a great start to his career. He's cashing in now, and now the key is, can he kind of follow through and give them that Super Bowl and the success that that contract kind of indicates?
A coach who has made a lot of money told me this week that if Patrick Mahomes, at his age, can play anywhere close to as well as Drew Brees and Tom Brady are playing now, much older, that will be a bargain. That when it comes up in 2031, they're going to be quarterbacks making a lot more than $50 million.
Well, that's true, too. And you're right. He's young. And if you see a quarterback like Tom Brady, Drew Brees have been around a long time, you know, if he has that sort of durability, then, yeah, he's certain. I mean, we see it all the time. Contracts go up and up and up. So if he's still that productive late in that contract, then I think I don't think that's crazy to say. That's going to be a pretty good value by then.
DeShaun Tate, if we figure that you're going to average, this might be low, but don't take it as an insult, $100,000 a year for the rest of your career, that means you would have to work 5,030 more years to make as much as Mahomes will in the next 12. You ready for that?
Wow. First of all, let me commend you on your math skills. I'm not nearly as good. If you ask me what's 2
plus 2. It's only 5,000 years.
You ask me what's 2 plus 2, I might tell you 22. But I'd gladly take all that cash. Let me tell you something. One of my biggest questions is, you know, who's the guy that's up next? We've heard about Stafford having a big deal, Matt Ryan having a big deal. Somebody always comes around and gets the bigger deal. This time it's Mahomes. I don't know who's going to top that next one around. He's at the top of the list. However, whatever you do, let's just keep him off of that Madden cover.
Matt, if we take a look at the top six salaries in the National Football League, and all of them are quarterbacks, behind Mahomes, you have Russell Wilson. He's certainly worth what he gets paid. Ben Roethlisberger injured a lot. Aaron Rodgers, still really good for Green Bay, but really getting up there in years, and they just drafted a quarterback. Jared Goff, hit and miss. Kirk Cousins, $33 million. When you look at these guys, Dak Prescott is the next one who is due. I can't imagine someone wanting to pay Dak Prescott $40 million. And I look at this list and I say, where's Tom Brady? Where's Deshaun Watson? Where is Lamar Jackson?
Well, those are all good questions, Jack. And to me, it's really kind of just the market, the way it works. You know, we're talking about the next quarterback up. Remember when Matthew Stafford signed his? You know, it was just a matter of time before he gets passed. And Tom Brady's a little different. I think he's taking a little bit less at times. But it's kind of just the way this market works. But then you look at it and say, there's a lot of guys on this list have been productive, won Super Bowls. Maybe not our friend Kirk Cousins, but I think he takes a little bit of undeserved heat because of that contract. But, you know, that's the position now. That's your value. If you are good enough, you're going to get that. The key is getting, you know, paying off and getting that team to the Super Bowl and getting that Super Bowl ring, and then you're one. That's why we're at the Dak Prescott. Is he worth it? Well, right now, probably not. They win a Super Bowl, then he's probably worth it. So that's kind of where we're at on that.
Yeah, the key word there is if.
Right.
DeShaun, you were talking about my math skills. I got another one for you here. when you think about the world's richest man, Amazon founder Jeff Bezos, and he is worth 225 times as much right now, tonight, as Patrick Mahomes is going to make in this $503 million contract. You know, you're talking about a guy worth $113 billion with a B. So It's relative. There's rich, there's obscenely rich, and there is unfathomably rich, of which we are none of the three.
Yeah, you know what? And I heard you mention those names. Where's Tom Brady? Where's Deshaun Watson? Where's Deshaun Tate on this list? That's the one I'm trying to figure out.
Deshaun Tate was with Steven Izzo on that roster list as a walk-on when it comes to that kind of money. We will be back in just a minute. Our Champions 2020 segment coming up next. Avery Peplinski of Owosso, this week's commencement speaker.
It's hard to admit that taking care of my mother is just becoming more than I can handle on my own. All my life, she's taken care of me. Now it's my turn to take care of her. I have to find my mom the best care.
At By Dawn's Early Light Home Care, we place importance on our clients' safety. We are doing our due diligence to ensure our clients and our caregivers are taking every necessary precaution during these times. Call us and set up a free care consultation today.
Sick and tired of being tired and sick? Experiencing brain fog and fatigue? Looking for increased vitality? Many people suffer from nutrient deficiencies, but there is hope. Wyckoff Wellness in East Lansing offers cutting-edge intravenous therapies, including IV nutrient infusions, ultraviolet blood irradiation, MAH ozone treatments, and more. Now through July 31st, Wyckoff Wellness is offering 20% off all their unique IV infusions during their July IV Extravaganza event. Save 20% both at the office and online at wyckoffwellness.com.
Know the day's weather before you walk out the door.
Fox 47 News.
Anyone who's had our chicken knows it's plump and juicy. What they may not know is that it's also 100% natural.
All our chickens are certified, humanely raised, no antibiotics, on a high-quality diet of soy and grain.
Why are they called tenders?
They're called tenders because they come from the tenderloin to the breast, hand-trimmed just for colors. It's not a strip or a finger. It is the true tenderloin.
I'll put our chicken tenders up against anybody's.
That's like my Granny Franklin used to make. That's outstanding, Craig.
Welcome to Delicious.
What's really important to me is being able to have a partner, and Dart Bank has been that for me. I'm Eric Nelson. I'm a managing partner here at the English Inn. I've worked with John Morris at Dart Bank to help put together multiple projects that have assisted us with growing our business and continuing to be successful.
A new day dawns and we greet it with gratitude. Thankful for the heroes on the front lines taking big risks daily to keep us safe. We at Dean Transportation stand at the ready with them, supporting our communities in their time of need. We've been delivering food and medical supplies, volunteering our time, and boosting morale to keep spirits high. Our passengers may have temporarily changed, but our commitment to transporting your most precious cargo has never wavered. Dean Transportation, working together, delivering the good.
Welcome back to Press Pass here on Fox 47. It's time for our Champions 2020 segment, brought to you by the Michigan Education Association. The MEA's members, educators from across our state, are proud of this year's high school graduates. Congratulations to each and every one of you. Learn more at MEA.org. Athletes aren't the only ones who've had to make adjustments this year. Commencement speakers doing things in a very different way. But Press Pass and the MEA giving an opportunity to 10 outstanding scholars to present their messages on behalf of the class of 2020. Tonight, we'd like you to meet Miss Avery Peplinski from Owosso High School. Hello, Avery. How are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Very good. You had an outstanding career at Owosso. We know you have big plans. We'll talk about that in just a minute. But first, we want to hear about 90 seconds of your address to fellow Trojans and students across the state of Michigan.
We have finished our high school journey, but I urge you to continue learning and growing as a human being. Whether you travel the world, decide to surround yourself with those different from you, or simply read about alternate viewpoints, there are many avenues to further educate ourselves on different perspectives and beliefs. Growth does not truly start until we leave our comfort zones and allow our conventional ways of thinking to be challenged. The class of 2020, I have a challenge for us. I challenge us all to do our best to become more cultured, well-rounded individuals and allies. We must push for equality for all and stand by those marginalized. I encourage you not to merely sit back and remain silent, but to make your voice heard and fight for those who have been silenced at the hands of oppression. While there are very few groups that I can say with certainty will change the world, I know that the class of 2020 will be part of the change I speak of today. Born in the aftermath of 9/11, entering society as adults during a pandemic and historic push for racial equality and acceptance of gender identity, we know a thing or two about the fight for justice and change. We have certainly experienced our fair share of social discord, but we have emerged stronger from it. Many of us have already taken the steps to become an ally and show our solidarity for various causes. So I ask you, keep posting, keep pushing, and keep the conversation going, for we can and will be the change this world so needs.
Wow, that was outstanding, Avery. DeShaun Tate, you know more about Lansing Waverly than you did about Avery, but what do you think of her message for social justice?
No, I didn't like it, Jack. I loved it. You know, when I'm thinking about the things that she said in her message, growing, learning and educating yourself, all those things being very, very extremely important. Congratulations to Ms. Poplinski.
Avery, why was that an important message for you to give? Why did you pick that message?
This was really important to me because I truly believe that we are a point in history where change is genuinely among us. This class has known our fair share of hardships, as I said, and we truly can be the catalyst for change. The world is going to completely change. It's been upended, and our generation is going to be entering in society where we have the capability to make it better than it previously was.
Four outstanding years in Owosso. Can you tell us about your future plans?
Yes, I will be attending the University of Michigan, where I am planning to major in biology on a pre-med track, and I'm also going to be studying French.
Well, I'll be working for her someday. Avery Poplinski, Owosso High School. Fantastic message. Really appreciate you joining us. We have three opportunities left in our Champions 2020 series. If you would like to give a speech or you know someone who should, contact me directly, jack@jackebling.net. We will be right back with our Cool and Smooth segment, our weekly awards, up next.
A new day dawns and we greet it with gratitude. Thankful for the heroes on the front lines taking big risks daily to keep us safe. We at Dean Transportation stand at the ready with them, supporting our communities in their time of need. We've been delivering food and medical supplies, volunteering our time, and boosting morale to keep spirits high. Our passengers may have temporarily changed, but our commitment to transporting your most precious cargo has never wavered. Dean Transportation, working together, delivering the good.
What's really important to me is being able to have a partner, and Dart Bank has been that for me. I'm Eric Nelson. I'm a managing partner here at the English Inn. I've worked with John Morris at Dart Bank to help put together multiple projects that have assisted us with growing our business and continuing to be successful.
Hi, I'm Deb Hart.
And I'm Bob Hoffman.
Have you checked out Fox 47 Morning News?
Every weekday morning, while Julie and Claire get you caught up on news and weather, we catch up with some of the most interesting people in mid-Michigan on the Morning Blend.
It's your chance to find out what's happening in your own backyard and have a little fun along the way.
Local news, local weather, local people.
Weekdays, 7 to 9 a.m.
I'm WWE superstar Kofi Kingston. Watch me on Friday Night SmackDown every Friday on Fox.
Every week, we get to play the fictional heroes on television.
And root for our heroes on the field.
We report stories about heroes of all types.
And we spotlight our local heroes every day.
But we wanted to take a moment
to thank the true heroes
of our time.
So, to all of you out there taking a risk for us, thank you.
Welcome back to Press Pass here on Fox 47. Time for our Cool and Smooth segment. brought to you by the five Culver's locations in mid-Michigan. Since 1984, Culver's has been delighting guests one meal at a time with scrumptious butter burgers and premium frozen custard. Swing through any Culver's drive-thru and grab your fresh favorites. That's Culver's. Welcome to Delicious. Look at the destruction. That is
the arena's demolition.
Implosion. Ah, we have the Palace of Auburn Hills going down. Like a lot of teams went down to play the Bad Boys.
Don't make
the
me
Palace of Auburn Hills.
Don't make me cry up here on the set, Jack.
You know, that was such a great arena to its last days. They put so much money into it. I'll bet that's still in the top third of NBA arenas in its final season. All right, Team 355, who has been as cool and smooth as a Culver's mint explosion? DeShaun Tate, what do you have for us for a play of the week?
The play of the week meets the player of the week, and that is none other than Mr. Joe Johnson, former Atlanta Hawk himself. The way that he's been carrying this team and just kind of looking like the MVP of the TBT so far,
yeah,
it is absolutely insane. I really laughed it off thinking that it was a complete joke talking about him maybe playing in the NBA. And I'm not saying he'd put these type of numbers back up at the logo.
Yeah.
However, the job that he has been doing has really been second to none. He's been outstanding.
Overseas elite.
Overseas elite.
Has been elite.
Yes, they have.
Multiple championships, but who's going to beat that team?
I don't know. It's looking very slim to none at this point. If Joe Johnson keeps playing the way that he is, I can't imagine that anybody would be able to seal that deal.
Our friend Steve Finnemore watching every play of the basketball tournament. All right. Matt Charboneau, what do you have for us for a team of the week?
Well, I'm not going to do so much the week, but the whole Palace implosion's got me feeling a little nostalgic. Seen my share of good games there, championship teams. I even got shushed at an Elton John concert there once. Who gets shushed at a concert? I don't know. That was Elton John. Anyway, that's not my point. I'm going back to my favorite team from the Palace. This is a pretty simple one and an easy one, right? It's the Bad Boy teams, the back-to-back NBA champions. I mean, those were my younger years, and who didn't love Rick Mahorn in there the first championship year, just kind of beating guys up? You had Isaiah and Joe. Just, I love that team. You love the tenacity of that team. And moving into that building just at the right time. Obviously, the 04 Piston Championship team was great, but I always have a soft spot in my heart for the Bad Boys. That was my team of the Palace, the team of the Palace era, I guess. And it was kind of sad to see the building go the other day, but we're going with the Bad Boys.
You know how much Matt Charboneau loves those Bad Boy Pistons. When he leaves the studio tonight, he's not going to shake your hand. He's not going to wish you well in any future endeavors. It's just going to be like the Bad Boys and the Chicago Bulls when they pass the torch.
Walk off.
Yeah, just exit, yeah. Drop the mic. All right, time for our player of the week. And this is a guy I've never talked about in this show before and never really thought I would, even though he's been to a Super Bowl, he's been an NFL MVP. He is the only player in NFL history to pass for 3,000 yards and rush for 500 yards, five straight seasons. That is not why I want to talk about Cam Newton tonight. Cam Newton did what I wish more athletes would do when they're financially secure, and that is to look for a championship, to look for the right situation. He signed a contract for the NFL minimum for his qualifications, just over $1 million to play for, of all teams, the New England Patriots. Can you imagine Cam Newton, Bill Belichick in that playbook? As soon as I say that, that means Jared Stidham will still be the quarterback for every game, or maybe it'll be some Spartan named Brian. But I have to think Cam Newton is really going to benefit from this new lease on life. And I hope instead of holding out for all the money in the world, that he makes it all back plus with that $1 million contract and then all the money you get as the quarterback of a Super Bowl champion. The first time I've ever said that about the New England Patriots. Want to thank Team 355, DeShaun Tate, Tate's Take Hoops, where basketball lives, and Matt Charboneau does a great job covering Michigan State football and basketball for the Detroit News. We'll be back next week, everyone. Have a great week.